Good evening. Many of us have seen the year 2020 as only a year of crisis. We have been at crossroads throughout, with ourselves, with work, with our relationship and the world around us. It has been a year of uncertainty. There has been a fear about how long life will last with the coronavirus, and with the environment failing us, it appears that we are losing control and nature itself is not cooperating. Families everywhere have dealt with anger, grief, and frustration. In other words, whether in Uganda or elsewhere in Africa or the world beyond, in a city or in the countryside, rich or poor, we have shared the loss of hope. This is a crisis not just about the pandemic we are fighting or the rebellion of nature with record heat, flooding, and loss of crops. The loss of hope we feel as an African family is because present circumstances have removed the band-aid on what we should have gotten right before this moment. Just 2 in every 10 people in Africa are gainfully employed. This means that most young people don't have the means to build on their dreams and connect their vision together as a future generation. If you think older people struggling with retirement are having it bad, imagine what it will feel like for the millennials. They are dealing with not just the joblessness of the pandemic, but the social crisis it has produced, the mental health crisis, the teenage pregnancy and early marriage crisis, violence in relationships at home and violence on the street when they protest their conditions. And when they survive the dangerous journey into other parts of the world, they also face racism and discrimination. They feel unwanted in the world where they know exactly what they want. And that is a right to life, liberty, and pursuit to happiness. But it is also my pleasure in these desperate times to report that the future must contend with the full and unexploited potential of young people today. It gives me hope personally that our problems, while considerable, don't compare to the passion and drive young people have to live a better life than the one they have now. I should know this because I'm surrounded by such energy here amongst my colleagues, which is the fellows from the Young and Emerging Leaders Project, and in my personal journey as an aspiring Member of Parliament in Uganda. Hope that a brighter future is not found wanting lies within us. Whether we find it lacking, we supply it with our own participation. Young people everywhere are not just surviving today's crisis, they are innovating and adapting. They are also stepping up to lead the way. Every generation is defined by its crisis. We have 2020 to showcase the many issues we contend with. But a generation without hope is also a lost generation. The good news is we are not that generation. It does not matter the hashtag, whether it's police brutality today or runaway corruption tomorrow. We will attack it with our passion as well as our ideas. Then we will move on to embrace a better world. Our generation's best and brightest are servant leaders ready to risk it all and put the interest of our communities first and their personal welfare last. In my present journey, I have been speaking about the potential of universal vocational education to add skills to whatever education young people have. This will allow us to take direct action against unemployment. It is a bold and practical idea. But it is based on the spirit of hope that remains present even when the headlines suggest the worst is on its way. Ladies and gentlemen, we are the hope and heart of our continent. It is our time to make Africa greater than it has been. Let us continue to drive positive change together to build the Africa we want. Our new beginning is a commitment to eternal hope, to personal and community growth, and to a common prosperity with a shared future in mind. Finally, I would like to thank the Little Africa Institute and the partners involved in the organization of this wonderful annual leaders gathering event, the first gathering of its kind for the Institute network across Africa. Thank you.